for the viewers who may not know you, they may just think of you as the son of a very powerful man, Congressman Zamora, one of three Zamora brothers, both in business and in politics. But you have quite a track record if people take the time to look. I mean, you were vice mayor twice already. Of course, you started as a counselor.
What, for one term?
All right. You came from La Salle and your postgraduate studies, you took it in New York University. You actually have a lengthy public experience considering you're quite young. And you have a lot of awards in San Juan. Why do you think you're the better candidate over, frankly, Janella?
Well, I have more experience. I have a better track record. I served as city councilor for one term, for vice mayor two terms. Before running for councilor, I handled my father's congressional district office.
Yeah.
And even in 2016, after not making it in the elections, I went back to the same position. I'm now currently handling my father's congressional district office. So since 2004 up to now, 2019, that has been 15 years of serving the people of San Juan.
But do you think, you know, do you see Janella as just a proxy of some sort?
Well, a lot of people say that the father was the one who was really pushing her to run for the position of mayor.
Meaning Jinggoy.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. But I guess only they can answer that.
Yeah. Yeah. If she wins, do you see her as leading San Juan or do you see Jinggoy as leading San Juan?
I see Jinggoy leading San Juan if she will win.
Uh-oh.
It is very obvious that Jinggoy is the one behind her candidacy.
Okay. Is that a good thing?
Well, it's not a good thing because people deserve a leader who can decide for themselves. Jinggoy has served San Juan already in the past, and if Janella wins, she should be the one who will lead the city herself, not the father.
Okay.
But that is the general perception of the people of San Juan, most especially the businessmen. The business sector are very worried that if Janella wins, Jinggoy will be the de facto mayor.
Now, if Jinggoy is the de facto mayor, I'm just pursuing a line of questioning here. Wouldn't that be good for San Juan? I mean, 50 years of the Ejercito Estradas, and some would say, look at San Juan today.
If Jinggoy becomes the de facto mayor, that means we're going back to the late 90s, early 2000s. Term of Jinggoy Estrada, where our budget was just 300 million pesos then. In fairness to Mayor J.V. Ejercito during his term, and of course Mayor Guia's term, the budget now is 2.5 billion pesos.
Okay, and why did that change? Well, how did that change?
If you will compare the Jinggoy and J.V. and Guia administration, during the time of Mayor Jinggoy, San Juan was really not progressive, and that is a fact. You have the budget as a basis, you have the development as basis. So if Jinggoy will become mayor again, quote unquote, then you are just going back to the old San Juan.
Okay.